We're about to start training today, and I wanted to remind you that if you are getting ready for the PMP exam, be it the pilot exam or the current exam, Agile is definitely a topic you want to be familiar with. So I wanted to remind you, the website is agileprinciple.com, where we are going to be going into more depth regarding Agile today. Now, in addition to that, we have the PMP exam pilot training, which is also happening today. And we're going to be talking about domain two, task one, all the way up. And in task one, I wanted to call your attention to what exactly the aim of this task is. And some key words, it says, execute the project with urgency required to deliver business value. So when you hear this term business value, we're really talking more about having a sense of delivering value to the business, that is the customer, if you will. We need to assess opportunities to deliver value incrementally. That reeks of Agile, obviously. Examine the business value throughout the project. Reeks of Agile, doesn't it? Support the team to subdivide project tasks as necessary to find the MVP. These are all Agile-related terms. So again, if you are struggling with understanding Agile, you definitely want to be in that training, agileprinciple.com. So your understanding of Agile is made more wholesome. I should also let you know that we're going to be making this available to our students for 3 months. Those who come on the agileprinciple.com program, for 3 months, they're going to have access to the videos that my trainer and I, Roy and I, are creating. So if you haven't been for any of our sessions before, Roy is an expert in the world of Agile, in the world of Scrum. He has helped many firms transition, big, small, and we're working together to deliver this to you so that you have a more wholesome idea of Agile, and when you encounter it on your exam, you will not be taken aback. So in task one, you need to have an understanding of requirement types, first of all, okay? Business requirements, stakeholder requirements, solution requirements, transition requirements, okay? You have to understand these requirements and the context of them. So when we talk about business requirements, the changeability of business requirements these days, it demands an Agile focus. I also wanted to call your attention to the Agile Practice Guide, figure 3-1. We can see here that in project management, it is not black or white. You have a continuum, as you can see, based on the degree of change. High degree of change, you want to be thinking more Agile. Low degree of change, you want to be thinking predictive, and that's okay. None of these is the devil. Predictive is not the devil. Agile is not the devil. Iterative ways of thinking and delivering stuff. It is all done to fulfill your business need. But if you're going to be Agile, okay? If you're going to be fully plan-driven for a project, you can incorporate some Agile principles. There's no hard and fast rule about it. What I am against is camouflaging that you are doing Agile, but you're really not. You're really creating some monstrosity, you know, that I'm against. And the Agile way of thinking cannot be disguised. People who truly know Agile would know. And that's why I say come have discussions with us so that you can really know what Agile is about, okay? If the frequency of delivery is low, you want to be thinking more on the predictive scale, on that continuum. So in task one, if you're getting ready for the pilot exam, there are a lot of things that you need to be aware of. Another page from the Agile Practice Guide is the hybridized approach mindset that you can carry out on a project. You could have an Agile development stage followed by a predictive rollout, or you might have a combination of Agile and predictive, and that's okay. But let's not call it Agile if it's hybrid. You know, that's really what I'm against. Okay. Hybrid models. It's not necessary to use a single approach for an entire project. Projects often combine elements of different life cycles in order to achieve certain goals. A combination of predictive, iterative, incremental, and or Agile approaches is a hybrid approach. You also need to be aware of iteration and flow-based Agile. Teams use Agile approaches in one of two ways, iteration or flow. Iteration-based agile means a team works in time boxes of the same size for every iteration. And there's an image which is not shown here. The team fixes the duration of the iteration. Teams often work in 1 or 2 week iterations of time box. Every 2 weeks, by definition, the team is done because the time box is over. The team doesn't change the duration because the team can't estimate what it can complete in a time box if it keeps changing the duration. In iteration-based agile, the teams work in iterations. As I said previously, the teams work on the most important feature, collaborating as a team to finish it, and then the next most important feature. The team may decide to work on a new feature at a time, but the team does not address all of the work for the iteration at once. That is, does not address all of the requirements, followed by all of the analysis, and so on. Now, the discussion of a sprint, we had this last week. It's a time box repetitive approach. If you've read the PMBOK Guide Chapter 6, and you go to 6.5, that whole dialogue about iterations, even though they're not explicitly called sprint all the way through, and you look at that image in the PMBOK Guide in Chapter 6.5, you'll have a better understanding of what is going on. The heart of Scrum is a sprint, a time box of 1 month or less during which a done, usable, and potentially releasable product increment is created. Sprints have consistent durations throughout a development effort. A new sprint starts immediately after the conclusion of the previous sprint. So we're going to talk about sprint planning and a lot of what happens in the world of Scrum, in the world of various agile-based approaches. But before we go today, I'll just hit the flow-based agile approach. The team pulls features from the backlog based on its capacity to start work rather than on an iteration-based schedule. So in this way, the team is taking on what they can at a time, but there's no hard and fast box to it. So think about it as more of a flow than more of a box, if you will. Now, when we talk about this particular task, we need to think about life cycles. It is important that you are aware on page 18 of the Agile Practice Guide, predictive life cycles, iterative life cycles, incremental and agile. There's a very informative page in the Agile Practice Guide, and I would recommend looking at that page to understand the delivery frequency of all of these, because this will help you understand one from another. Predictive with a one-time delivery. Agile, multi-deliveries over a period of time, and so on. Take a look at that, and it's going to help you better understand what is going on in this task. Talking about hybrids, agile teams rarely limit their practices to one agile approach. Each project context has its own peculiarities, such as the varied mix of team member skills and backgrounds, the various components of the product under development. So for those of you that have not really gone into this, when we say agile, agile is a collection of flavors. Excuse me, agile is not just one flavor. I know a lot of times when we say agile, people immediately think about Scrum because it's the most widely used agile flavor. But that does not mean that other approaches cannot be used. So agile approaches could be mixed. You could find a team using Scrum. You could find that same team using Kanban in addition. You could find that same team in some ways using TDD. So we cannot restrict Agile to just Scrum. That is important to note. But Scrum is by far the most demonstrative, illustrative, very easy to grasp illustration of how the Agile mindset should work. Okay? So again, if you are getting ready for the PMP exam, I would highly advise that you come aboard, study with us. You know, we want to make sure that you are in ship shape for the exam, okay? Again, the website, if you're getting ready for the PMP exam, you listen carefully because there are two sites to be aware of. The first is the agileprinciple.com site, where we are going into nothing but agile, just very, very agile focused in our studying. And that is from 3 p.m. Eastern to 5 p.m. Eastern. If you want to be part of the PMP prep for the pilot exam, which I tell you will also help you for the current, you want to go to pmsucceed.com. All right. I hope this gives you some clarity on the importance of agile as you get ready for not just the pilot exam and not just the current exam, but also, of course, the future exam, which is starting on July 1st. This whole narrative and understanding is going to help you. Bye for now.